So this is not clickbait, this is real, this is my experience. I was able to make over 1,000 subscribers and over 4,000 watch hours in a space of 1 month, in March 2020 to be specific. I'm going to put up my analytics first, my emails from YouTube, you know, the feedbacks and stuff that I've been getting, so you can understand. Then after I put that, so you can relax and actually understand how I was able to achieve this in this short period of time. So if you're struggling with your channel, or if you're still thinking of starting a YouTube channel, then this video is definitely for you, and you should definitely keep watching. First of all, I'd like to state that this is not some kind of holy grail of how to make it successfully on YouTube, but this video, I promise you, are definitely going to get one or two things that can change your YouTube game and also help you to achieve your own aim in YouTube. So starting off, I'm going to put up my analytics. This is my analytics for the month of March. This is my I started this channel in February 2020. This is a picture to show you from my about page. This is exactly when I started the channel, and I started to post a few weeks later, and then this is what I was able to achieve in March, filming with my own iPhone and also staying at home during quarantine, and this is what I was able to achieve in a month. So if I could do it, anybody can actually do this. So if I can get this much hours, first of all, watch hours, 4 hours watch hours is equal to 240,000 minutes. That is a lot for most small YouTubers. I can attest, because I had this other channel that I started late last year. I worked on it for a few months, and it was extremely difficult because I put so much work into it and I wasn't getting results. After a few months, I was having 5,000 views. It was really depressing and discouraging, and I had to think of something else. So this is what I was able to achieve in this short period, and these are the mails from when I got my 100 subscribers, when I got my 1,000 subscribers, and then this is the last mail I got from YouTube, when they told me, you have passed the threshold of 1,000 subscribers and over 4,000 hours. You should definitely monetize your channel, so you are open and free to apply now. I already applied a few days ago. I know that it's going to take some time. They even told me after I applied, they said, please expect some delays because of this pandemic that is going on in the world. We have less workers and things are going to go slower than normal, and it's fine, I understand. So this is my space. I'm going to see, update you guys on how the monetization journey goes, but this is what I was able to achieve in a space of 1 month, and you too can do it. So you should definitely keep watching, as I'm going to be sharing step by step of how I was able to achieve this success in March. So turning around this quarantine into something good and making a whole lot of progress on my YouTube channel is something to be proud of. I'm really excited, and I want to say this for all aspiring YouTubers or small YouTubers. If you have been thinking that, oh, for me to start a successful channel, I have to have the beautiful camera, I need to have the high-end editing softwares and all that, I can tell you that that is not what you need to grow your channel. That is not, like, yes, it's good to have good cameras, to have good pictures, good quality and all, and the best top-notch editing software. Those things can come along the line. You don't have to start with them if you cannot afford them. In fact, it's even easier to film and edit with your phone, especially for beginners that don't know anything about editing, because this is a learning process. There's no way you can stay outside the door of YouTube and just know how it works. You must experiment, you must try, and you must see what works and what doesn't work. Sometimes you'll be like, okay, this video idea is going to be a hit, and at the end of the day, nobody's even interested, and the one that you put less effort into, you see a lot of people clicking it, a lot of hours come from it. So you must experiment before you know, so you don't just stay outside and be planning how to start your channel for years and you've not started. So right now you are watching me, you probably have a phone, you should definitely start filming yourself and start doing something, because the earlier you start, the earlier you make the required watch hours and the subscribers needed. Now, the most important thing that you need to make your channel successful is content. Once you have a good content that people are searching for, people are interested to watch, then you are on your way to making this 4,000 watch hours in a very short time. So for me, content is king, you know. So that is the first thing. You should definitely write it down. Content over camera, over editing. Content that people are looking for. Searchable content that people have been searching for, that will be useful to teach people and educate people or entertain people. You just have to be a need for it. Don't just put videos out there and it's not serving any purpose. Don't expect anybody to watch it. Put videos that you know that you could watch if you are a viewer, a general viewer, that they bring this recommendation to your timeline, you are going to click and watch it. So content is the number one. Write that down. So moving on to the second one. So my second point that I feel like is worthy of note is, as a small YouTuber that is starting, do not limit yourself by sticking to only one particular niche, especially when the niche is not paying off. If you have tried it for a few days, a few weeks, and you are not seeing the results, feel free to generalize. Feel free to try other things. Feel free to throw in different niches and see the one that works for you. If you are new, don't expect to be like, okay, I'm going to do my lifestyle vlog, I'm going to video my life, my family, and just put out there and automatically people are going to watch. No, if you're not a celebrity, you're not an influencer, it's difficult for people to be interested in your life. I mean, nobody is searching for your surname on YouTube, nobody is searching for your family on YouTube. So you shouldn't just, you know, lifestyle vlogs are good, but I feel like you should try other niches that are dragging people to your channel, what people are searching for. Then when you feel like you have some level of audience, can also introduce and mix it. Nobody is saying you must stay to this particular niche. This is what a lot of big YouTubers keep telling you, but it's not like that anymore. Maybe it was like that when they were growing, but this is 2020. A lot of people watching on YouTube. You should be able to grab a few of those millions of people logging onto YouTube every day to your channel. So you should be able to do videos, generalize it, try this niche, try that niche, what are people searching for, what is trending, talk about it, make videos and create content around it. That way you get people. There's no way when people watch your video, there won't be a few of them that will be like, okay, I like this face that I'm seeing. Oh, I like what I'm seeing here. Let me just subscribe. And the more subscribers you have, the higher video views that you get in your subsequent videos. So I believe generalization is the second point. Make sure you write it down. Don't limit yourself so much to one niche, especially when you're just growing, because nobody is really interested in that one. If it's not working, try something else. Don't make it limited to just, oh, I have to stick to this and grow my particular niche. It's not true. Some people don't care, they just watch anything you put. So if you are scared that a few hundred subscribers you have are just going to leave if you put something else, then they are not even the subscribers you need, because you need thousands, millions of subscribers. So if these few hundred are going to make you limit yourself to this one, you're scared of them leaving, then they should leave, because you're working on getting this aim, this 4,000 watch hours. It's not a joke. So you should be able to generalize and find out what works for you, and over time you will find the videos that bring in more audience, that make, you know, get more views for you and more watch hours. Then you can actually make more on this particular niche. Going straight to point number three, I'm going to talk about something that a lot of people keep saying: passion. Yes, passion is needed for all walks of life. You know, any business or anything you want to start, it's very good for you to have passion for it. You know, but I feel like this passion sometimes is overrated, because what you have passion for might not be of interest to a lot of people on YouTube. So it's just like saying, oh, I only like to do this, and I'm going to make videos only on what I like. You're going to take a lot of time to be able to get there, and it becomes work over time, and that passion and the joy is gone. For example, I started this other channel, My Handy Franny. I started it late last year. I was so into doing my do-it-yourself projects. I love to do-it-yourself. I love to sew. I do those things for fun. I decided, okay, I can actually make a YouTube video around this topic. So I started. I didn't expect a lot of influx, but at least I expected some kind of encouragement for all the work I put behind the scenes to sew, I put behind the scenes to create these pieces. And then to get 100 views or 150 views is a lot of work. Most of my videos are under 200 views, and you just get tired, because you have to put a timeline on your passion. So you say, this is something I do for fun, I do them when I feel like, but because I'm not doing YouTube video, I have to sew every 2 days or every 3 days or every day to put up content so people can come to my channel. And then the interest in this particular passion started to go away. Whenever I think of sewing, I feel discouraged, because like, I'm going to go through this process of filming, because it's a different when you're just sewing for fun, and then when you have to film, explain, stop, pause, go back, you know, it just kills the passion over time, especially when the interest is not much. So you should know that there's a limit. You know, don't just depend on what you like, because a lot of people do not like what you like. So you should look for something that appeals to a wide audience and work with it. That's this, whether you like it or not, YouTube is a business. We are all doing it here. A lot of people, I don't know about everybody, but me and a lot of people, and even you that are here, a lot of you are doing it because you want to monetize, you want to make some kind of passive income from YouTube, or even a full-time income from YouTube. So we know that it's a job, and you should, you know, buckle up and face it and put a lot of hard work and know that you should work on something that's not exactly perfect for you, but something that is going to generate the views that you need and also get to the pay that you're looking for, the checks that you're looking for. So nobody really enjoys putting videos every day, but this is what you need. So you don't have to rely solely on what you like. You should look for things that are trending and what people are searching for. And most important point, and the tactics, my own strategy that I use, is consistent hard work. Please write this down. This cannot be said enough. Like, consistent hard work is very, very important for YouTube success. If you can go through my channel, you will see that there were days where I posted two videos. I was posting every single day. I wake up and sometimes I don't feel like, as I'm taking my breakfast, I just go through my analytics to see how my videos from the previous day. And when I see the growth, when I see the number of people that watch these videos and also comments, you know, I feel more encouraged to just sit down and shoot more videos. So if you are working on a niche that requires a lot of days to be able to make one video and then another extra 2 days or a day to be able to edit it, then I think you should also add more. You know, I'm not saying you should abandon the niche you've been working on, but you should look for something else that requires you just sitting down in front of your camera and talking. You know, it takes less time to talk, it takes less time to edit, and then you can be able to put more than one video every day. So for those people telling you put one video once a week and try to put one video once a week, to be honest, it's very difficult to achieve your aim with that. Let me just tell you the truth. If you're not a celebrity, you're just a small YouTuber, upcoming YouTuber, regular person like me, then putting videos once a week is not going to cut it. That is just the truth, plain truth. So once a week is just a joke, it's not going to cut it. You're going to grow, but very slow. You're not going to make that in 1 year unless you are very, very lucky. So you should think of something that you can put videos 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times a week, and if possible more than one video a day, because I did this in 1 month because I was putting 2-3 videos in 1 day. Yes, it's possible. If you're working on a niche where you just talk, you know, you just sit down and talk, just try to research, get a lot of knowledge and talk. That way you can push out, especially in the initial time. I'm not saying you must continue with this routine, you know, it's not compulsory to continue, but at least this will build faster audience that are interested in your content into your channel. That way you can now start to limit it. When you're not really in the mood, you can start to take it less, you know, easier. But in the beginning, you need to push. There is no break. I'm happy this quarantine period, I used it very well. I'm not going anywhere, I'm not going to work, I just sit down and I film, and I'm quite encouraged when I wake up the next morning and check my analytics and I see what my views, I see what my watch hours are. I'm so excited to shoot the next day's video. And then another thing that you must note as a small YouTuber, a lot of people, because we are desperate for watch time, we start to put videos 20 minutes, 15 minutes, 25 minutes, you know, all those long videos are not going to work very well for your own ranking. You know, when you think about the analytics and the algorithm of YouTube, you should think about making short length videos, because they're going to favor you as a small YouTuber. If someone is going to give you a try, you know, for the first time, like, oh, who is this? This is a new channel I've never seen, and the person comes into your channel and then you're rambling for 20 minutes, you don't expect someone to just sit down there watching you for 20 minutes. So you should limit it and make it less than 5 minutes is good for a starter. Yes, I know you want to get more watch time, but with time, you will see that the short videos are gathering the watch time that you need. And when you make short videos, like if you can, there's maybe a chance where I had 3 videos in a day. There was a way that I could have actually merged those 3 videos and make them one, and then they'll be like almost 20 minutes. But I thought about, you know, making them different videos into 3. That way, when YouTube is recommending my videos, I have 3 chances. You know, they put first thumbnail, somebody sees it, then they don't want to click that one. They see the second one, oh, this one looks interesting, let me watch. Another one will still come, all from my channel. There's no way someone will see the 3 of them and not want to click one. So that is why the short videos are important, I think, because people are not interested in watching your video 20 minutes. It's not like you're a celebrity or something very interesting to keep them to watch till the end. And it's important to also get a good percentage of your watch time. You know, watch retention ads is very important, because when YouTube checks and people just click into the video and they're out, a video of 20 minutes, somebody's watching only 2 minutes, that way you have maybe like 10% watch time, is really bad. So YouTube will stop recommending that video over time. So less people will see it and less views you will have for that particular video. But when you have a video of 5 minutes and someone watches for 2.5 minutes, you already have 50% retention time, which is pretty good for a starter. If you have 50% retention, YouTube will be like, okay, people are actually watching this video all to the halfway, or even all, you know, above half. I'm going to recommend it to more videos, more people, because people seem to be interested in this video. And that way your video is being pushed for more recommendations, suggestions. When people are watching videos, it just comes up like, you should definitely watch, I'm recommending this video for you. And the more people are clicking on the recommendation, they are going to push it to even more people. So on the long run, the short ones pay off more. This is a confusion a lot of people have. I also had it. I felt like I had to put out long videos to get more watch hours. But the views are going to drop over time. After the first day, there's probably no one seeing it anymore, because the retention is so poor. So YouTube will just stop recommending it and put videos that people are interested in. So let's think about that as well, because the shorter videos are going to get to more people and you're going to have more views, and it's going to work for your channel, because YouTube will see your channel, oh, people are interested in this channel, so let's push it out there. So this is what I've noticed about this algorithm, and it has been working for me. And I think you should also think about it and consider it when you're making your next video. I am actually tired of talking. I don't make these long ass videos normally, but I just feel like this topic is very important. I had to quick, you know, touch the points that I can remember that are very important that I use that worked for me. So right now I have applied for the monetization. I am waiting, you know, it's in progress. I don't know how long it's going to take. It might take longer, but I'm going to definitely update you on my journey, on what I get, on hopefully they can monetize me as soon as possible. Hopefully I don't have any problems of having to go back and reapply and stuff. So this is it for this video, guys. Thank you for watching to the end. If you like this video, do not forget to give me a thumbs up. If you're an aspiring YouTuber, you're still thinking of starting your channel, or you're struggling with your channel as a small YouTuber, then you should definitely consider subscribing to this channel, because I intend sharing more of my experience as I go along. I feel really lucky to have made so much success in the space of 1 month, and I feel like there's so much more I can share with my experience over time as I grow. And I'm going to share my monetization journey, and I'll be as transparent as possible. So if this is of interest to you and you think it can help your YouTube journey, then you should definitely subscribe to my channel, because there is so much more coming from where this came from. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on my next video. Make sure you click the notification bell as well, so you'll be notified when I drop any of my videos. Thank you so much, guys, and I'll see you on my next video.